This mount has quite a bounce to it. Half his health. It's time to do what's right, for certain values of right. Look at that notice board. Probably for those looking for a ride away from this place. You're getting close to a sludge-make finery. The Toxinol Corporation used these to turn sludge into go-juice. The process fouled the skies for miles around. Maybe, but not nearly as much as they cared about all the green they made. Step careful around the sludge, and you might spot some old tracks. Don't waste too much energy. Look at that notice board. Probably for those looking for a ride away from this place. You're getting close to a sludge make finery. The Toxinol Corporation used these to turn sludge in. Toxinol, you. Maybe not much to eat around here, though. The subtle sound of metal creaking should mean the tie down is nearby. Someday you'll be able to do that, but it's not today. Hey, there's some rubber scrap over there, just ripe for the taking. If the mount didn't throw you, you're good. Found it. This here is the village of Fruckle.
Tile Tala.
Give it a little kick.
So not tele, mela, trae us end ulagnu tele weather, mihuibule.
Glad you ran into out of date. Heard he lives in a cave beneath the tree of life.
Tulu quanti.
Understands completely.
Titsula sakta uyupe.
Complains it's heart-busting raising young ones when the world end leaves no future for them. But they think Maytimes collecting a set of pets might help them hold up. They're too busy watching the... Thinks one for each kidling would do. They fight over them other ways. Kidlings and scrips. Claims those petables are all over the place. Just gotta scoop them up. Once you get enough critters for each kidling, that should be plenty. Without enough critters, the kidlings get stanky cranky. Says you're the kind of end friend they all need.
Thank you.
Will the dawn never come? Let's see. Careful with your water. The world is taller than you think. Grab tight and don't let go. Don't be fiery. It probably won't bite. Look at that metal scrap over there. This one seems to be in good spirits, despite being left here for dead. Has heard that you have a sense of compassion and trusts it's in your nature to help those in need. Asks you to do the right thing, is grateful you...
Doc, please, before...
Oh, no need to shout. I'm still...
Not for long.
Even here, the night still ends. The sky is as bright as it's going to be. That's Ranchu, an entire farm poisoned by toxinol rads. Don't stay there long. Check out that rubber scrap. Someone has to end this plague before it's too late. You need to harmonize the notes. Just a few moves left. Make them count. That's an earful. You need to harmonize the notes. Music to anyone's ear. Stories only survive if someone is listening, so pay attention. That's a good find. Always good to have some wood scrap like that on hand. Here you got Bo's teak hanging in that little blimp. Has an upgrade bench too. Let's see. Smell that. It's the Glurp paddock. Chubsa must be nearby. He's heard what's happened to you and wouldn't have blamed you a bit if you'd given up and gone on back home. He'd have done that long ago. Claims it's always with him, no matter where he goes. For now. He's impressed by the courage needed to get you to this point. He knows that he'd have strayed from the path long ago. Under threat or not, the thought of home is just too appealing to him. He hopes that you'll find a way to save the Tree of Life, and along with it, the world and all the homes in it. Including his. If your home means anything to you, well, he doesn't care. He just wants you to think about those like him who can't do much to save theirs. Sometimes he wonders what life would be like if he lived somewhere else. Different home, different him. Supposes that's why you came back here after being gone so long. Home always calls your name. Kind of expected the world to end like this. He's going to miss his home most of all. Believes you tried your best to make things better, and not just for yourself. Heard you've been nesting with the Jagni. Surprised they'd let you out of their places. They're so dedicated to grabbing everything they can get their fingers on. Thinks that's a polite way of saying they'll take your stuff if you give them a chance. The homes of others don't really matter that much, though. He says whatever you think, big isn't better. It's just bigger. What you see here isn't what you get. There's more going on than meets the eye. His name is Chubsa. A name doesn't mean much, maybe, but you should know he's built his foundation on something larger than himself. Now, with the world on the brink of destruction and all, the time has come for him to find a new home that's better suited to his needs. Says bigger just means bigger. Sometimes you need the space, not want, need, and that's often out of your control. Chubsa says there's no place like home. Even though he's on it, in mind, heart, and body, he feels he's far from the place he wants to be.
Mashaku hersave, vaksan u intabaran kamaglai.
If you truly get in touch with something from the scorched earth, like a carrot, you get in touch with the land in such a way you feel in touch with true life. Once he gets going, you'll understand.
Wow.
Chubsa wonders if you've seen any carrots in the ground nearby. He's been needing one for a while, but now he needs to act before it's too late.
Dana undisavela.
As long as it's not after it's swallowed down.